Hey guys, today I'm going to be doing a book review on The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy by Douglas Adams. Arthur Dent is having a very bad day. His house is about to be bulldozed away, but before that can even happen, his friend Ford tells him that the Earth is about to be annihilated by extraterrestrial forces. Arthur and Ford escape from Earth just in time, and as they travel through space, they read from The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy in order to help them navigate through the wide expanses of space. I went into this book knowing that it's supposed to be funny, that it's supposed to be a satire of the sci-fi genre. And I also went into this book knowing that it's supposed to be really random and weird. But even knowing all of this information, it still caught me by surprise in some ways, and I wasn't expecting just how random and weird this book was going to get. I am very split on my feelings in regards to this book. Part of me liked it, but then part of me just kind of was really bored with it. For the most part, I did find myself laughing out loud on occasion. A lot of the writing was just so hilarious and so brilliantly done. And a lot of it was a really great commentary on our society. There's all this really fantastic commentary on the government, on economy, on digital watches, religion, intelligence, life and death. And it's all done in a very humorous way, but in some ways very, very subtly done. What I particularly liked the most about this book was actually the very first half. I really loved the weird dynamic between Arthur and Ford, and that is what I latched onto the most. When Arthur and Ford ran into these two other characters named Zepod and Trillian, that's when the book kind of started going downhill for me, and I started not to enjoy it as much. So yeah, I liked the first half when Arthur and Ford are kind of just, they're out, you know, up in space, and they get into all these really messy situations, and things just aren't going right, and it's all so hilarious. And the start of this book just opens in a really fantastical way. The Earth is about to be annihilated by extraterrestrial forces, and it's just so hilarious to witness Arthur trying to kind of process this fact. Arthur is kind of just thrown into events, and he doesn't quite know what to do with himself. And then in the meantime, you have Ford, who you find out is an alien, and he's just very nonchalant about the whole thing, like, oh, it's just the Earth. I'll read from you a little paragraph with Arthur trying to process the annihilation of Earth, because he's trying to provoke some sort of reaction in himself about what it is he's going to miss the most. So here it is. England no longer existed. He'd got that. Somehow he'd got it. He tried again. America, he thought, was gone. He couldn't grasp it. He decided to start smaller again. New York was gone. No reaction. He never seriously believed it existed anyway. The dollar, he thought, has sunk forever. Slight tremor there. Every Bogart movie has been wiped, he said to himself, and that gave him a nasty knock. McDonald's, he thought? There is no longer any such thing as McDonald's hamburger. He passed out. When he came round a second later, he found he was sobbing for his mother. So yeah, just judging from that paragraph, you can kind of see that satirical humor there, which is really, really well done. In general, I did really like this set of characters. The book is kind of only a little over 200 pages long, so there's not much in the way of this really great character development. But I still enjoyed the characters for just their personality alone. Arthur represents the everyman. He is the one that we are experiencing this journey with. Ford was probably my favorite character. He is an alien, but he's on Earth posing as a human, and he's doing research on his book, The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. I think why I might have liked Ford so much had to do that I saw him as this sort of anti-doctor sort of character. Anti-doctor meaning I'm referring to Doctor Who. Then there's Zepod Beeblebrox, And the one word to describe him is that he's just a very manic sort of character. He's very much kind of like, it's all cool, man. He's kind of hippy-dippy. And then there's Trillian, and she's kind of just the token woman on the team. Nothing much is even done with her, but I still liked her. And then you have Marvin, who is a depressed, suicidal android. And now that I think about it, while I'm sitting here talking about this book, these characters have absolutely nothing in common. They kind of don't really even get along that well. And that kind of just made me think of kind of the relationship between, like, Marvel's the Guardians of the Galaxy. This book is kind of like that as far as character relationships go. So that was the stuff that I really liked about this book. So getting into why I didn't particularly enjoy this novel so much and why I gave it a 3-star rating, it all had to do with the fact that I felt like a lot of this material kind of just flew right over my head. I'm not a very big sci-fi reader. I only read it occasionally, especially if there's some sort of book that's being hyped about and I think I'll have an easy time getting into it. The technical mumbo-jumbo in this book often overwhelmed me. Even some of the commentary on occasion kind of flew right over my head because I didn't quite grasp it, and it would get really deep and just really all into the subject, and I just didn't get it. Deep and intellectual, that's the way to put it. The book was the most strongest when it would focus on the characters themselves. That is what I was able to latch onto and connect to. But sometimes the book would go into these random tangents and just talk about something random. They would go on some random adventure, and I never quite knew how that connected to the overall plot of the story. Maybe it wasn't supposed to connect. It often felt like Douglas Adams, as he was writing, was kind of saying to the reader, "Hey, look what I did there. Did you just see what I did? Did you just see how clever and witty I was?" And that, quite honestly, really made me feel stupid on occasion. And I don't like feeling stupid while I read, because it often felt like Douglas Adams was trying to say, "Hey, look how deep and intellectual I can be, and guess what? You're not going to get it." Overall, I did like this book. I didn't love it. I didn't hate it. I was just very in between with it. Like I said, I liked the first half the most. I honestly just don't understand all the hype in regards to this book. Is there something I'm missing? I am kind of interested in picking up the rest of the series, because they're all short anyway. They wouldn't take up that much time in regards to reading. And the story kind of left off in a cliffhanger, and I'm curious where that's going. I think this book works best if you are an extreme lover of sci-fi and if you really like a comedic sort of commentary on current issues. But yeah, if you're not a big sci-fi reader, this book may be kind of off-putting to you. So that's it for this review. Have you guys read The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy? Do you want to read it? Just let me know in the comments below, and I'd love to have a conversation with you. So that's it, you guys. I hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you liked this book review, you may like these other book reviews. Bye, guys.